Hey guys, welcome back to our Beer of the Week, and for this week we have Pile of Face by Against the Grain Brewery. This is an American IPA, and it has an ABV of 6.5, and the can says, "In a world where all the skulls are being used up, we are left with nothing but piles of face. But fear not, that's where the story is truly told. Pile of Face is the institution of American IPA. With all the character and drinkability you would expect as we celebrate American indulgence." And it says 48 degrees to be served at and drink from the can. Today we will not be drinking from the can, but rather a pint glass. It actually has really cool artwork as well. Let's see there, dude's reaching in out of a bucket of face, and it was just like a shish kebab of faces there. A bunch of eyeballs. You see at the bottom there with the ABV and the temperature to be served at. But yeah, this is actually my first beer from them, and I have never had it before. I don't know what to say. I don't know what to expect. So let's get this into a glass, see what it looks like, see what it smells like. Alright, so it poured with about a finger of just white head. Looks pretty frothy. Yeah, just a finger of white frothy head. It poured like a semi hazy golden color. I can see there's carbonation just seeping up there. Not a ton of carbonation, it looks like, but there is carbonation in there. But yeah, it's just like this hazy-ish golden color. But by no means it's like, you know, one of those super hazy beers that everyone's looking for. Yeah, it's just like a hazy golden color. Let's see what it smells like. I'm not getting a whole lot of anything from it. Like, I smell something, it just smells super clean, super crisp. Like a beer you would drink on a very hot day. But there's nothing too crazy about it. It smells kind of like fresh cut grass as well, like in the best way possible for a beer. I mean, not like, you know, I know some people don't like the smell of, you know, fresh cut grass, me being one of them, just because I have allergies. And yeah, like fresh cut grass just means it's allergy season. Like a little, like a sweet malty kind of smell to it as well. I'm not getting a whole lot of citrus smell, like very faint, like orange peels or something, but it definitely does smell like fresh cut grass with like this sweet like smell to it. I'm not quite sure what that is, but yeah, let's get a taste. Cheers. Yeah, it pretty much just tastes exactly what it smells like this very crisp and like clean taste to it. It has this breadiness on the finish, like as the beer finishes, it has this like sweet breadiness that makes it very, very enjoyable. Like, this is a very easy drinking beer for sure. This is definitely like a beer you could have multiple of and, you know, and be fine. Look at our taste. Yeah, just that breadiness, that sweet breadiness on the back of your tongue when, you know, when it finishes, it's just, I like it. It just keeps you wanting more. But there is definitely like a citrusy note to it, like orange peels, maybe tangerine peels or something like that. But those are not like the large like flavors of this beer. And there's that faint like fresh cut grass taste as well. Like it all just meshes really well. Like nothing's really overpowering anything. Everything just works really well together, and there's a very for being an IPA, it's very low bitterness. Like, I forgot that it was even an IPA. That's how low the bitterness is on this beer. Yeah, very, very drinkable and very easy drinking beer. I have never had a beer from Against the Grain before, like I said before, but I can tell you that this will not be my last for sure. Yeah, the head didn't last very long. There's some lacing, but being at 6'5", I mean, you don't expect too much, right? Some lacing, not crazy, but very, very easy drinking beer. Yeah, just that, like that malty-ish, breaded, like a bread taste when it finishes. Like, it's sweet and it's like yeasty, I guess. Makes it a very, very good beer. I'm kind of curious as to see what it's rated as on Beer Advocate. So I'm gonna finish this off, and we'll go right to it. Cheers. Yeah, very good beer. Oh, we'll probably get another can of this. Or maybe a few more, actually. Well, let's get on to the reviews. Alright, so reading from Beer Advocate. It has no score yet. And it says awaiting 10 reviews. But the first reviewer gave it a 3.69 out of 5. And they said it pours an effervescent is slightly hazed gold with two fingers of pearl-colored head, persistent effervescent, below average lacing, and no head retention. Smell faint grassiness and breadiness, mango once warm. Taste, slight breadiness and tangerine, dryness and pear up front, mango and tangerine, dryness and grassiness as this warms. Finishes with pomelo, dryness and grassiness. Mouthfeel, medium, fairly restrained carbonation, good balance, drinks easy, but nothing special here. So pretty much I agree with most of it. I drank mine, it came straight from the fridge, so I didn't get any of the mango or mango and tangerine dryness and grassiness. Mango and tangerine dryness and grassiness as this warms. So I didn't get any of that. I mean, I got perhaps tangerine peels or something like that, the grassiness, but once again, this came straight from the fridge, and I got the tangerine and the grassiness. I didn't get the mango. The dryness, I can relate to that. But yeah, it looks like grassiness is like a thing. Like, I'm not just making it up, which even if I was, I mean, my opinion, right? Mouthfeel. They said it's medium, fairly restrained carbonation. Like, I initially said, it looks like it has some carbonation, a whole ton of it. But, it maybe just it's because I drank all of it at once, which is why I felt like a lot of carbonation buildup. But I could be wrong. Like, to me, it felt like it was more than medium carbonation. It's like I guess a medium plus or something like that, would I say in the last video, because I read some dude's review and it was freaking hilarious. But it was like a medium plus, I guess, carbonation to me. Mouthfeel, I mean, it was like drinking water, I guess. I did just like a light mouthfeel, like, you know, like what you would expect an IPA to feel like. Like, it's not chewy, I guess. It's not like a stout or, you know, like a thick, juicy, you know, hazy kind of like beer, like all of those haze craze beers that are coming out. But yeah, just, you know, a solid IPA to me. This next one's way too long to read, so I'll skip and go to this guy. And they gave it a 3.9 out of 5, and it says, can into a snifter, clear golden with a little bit of haze, two fingers of bubbly white foam, notes of grapefruit, melon, citrus, grass, and light malt on the nose. Big aroma at first, but it faded as the head settled. A lot of grassiness on the taste with backing notes of hop resin, grapefruit, citrus, tangerine, and bready malt. Not overly flavorful, but not bad. Nice, light, but creamy feel. Easy drinking. Not the best I've ever had, but a great lawnmower beer. Maybe it's because, I don't know, I don't do a very aggressive pour at all, as you can tell. I just do a pour, right? I'm not trying to get all the beer in there all at once. Maybe that's why I'm not getting, the two fingers of head that everyone else is getting. I'm getting that one that you saw. He got notes of grapefruit. I can see where he got that. Melon, I didn't get. Citrus, grass, light malt in the nose. And a bready malt kind of flavor. Definitely got all that. And the smell, he said it faded away as the head settled. Like I told you, when I tried to smell it, right, with the head and everything, there was not a whole lot going on for it. Like, you can smell kind of like a sweetness, grassiness, yeasty kind of smell, I guess. But like, I really had to try to like smell that. Like, it wasn't like it just was right there for you. So, I don't know. But yeah, they only have one more review, so I'm just gonna read it as well. So this person gave it a 3.83 out of 5. They said, aroma is very floral, citrusy grapefruit juice, tangerine, resin, fresh cut grass with a toasted malt note. Flavor is more citrus, pith dominant with a touch of juice and a piney, resiny, herbal, bitter finish. Sure? I got fresh cut grass, toasted malt, grapefruit, I suppose. But not really, I didn't get the citrus pith, I guess, or the pininess. I got, if any pininess at all, very little. I didn't get no resiny taste or herbal bitter finish, but like I said, it was very low bitterness for being an IPA and makes it super drinkable. Not saying that I don't like bitter beers, but it was very low bitterness, and it was just like, it was a very drinkable, very easy drinking beer overall, and it definitely would not be my last Against the Grain beer, I can tell you that. I almost forgot to give my rating on the beer. It doesn't look like anyone's giving it a 4, so not because of that I'm gonna give it a 4, but just because of like the drinkability and the little bready sweetness in the end that keeps you wanting more from the beer. Yeah, so that's where I stand with Against the Grain, Pile of Face. Let's do a 4 out of 5. That is my rating. So that is it for the reviews, and that will be it for this video as well. I hope you guys liked this week's Beer of the Week. Join me next week for another one, and as always, dream big dreams and believe all things are possible, and thank you for watching.